We spend a considerable amount of time every day in meditation to counteract the daily subliminal bombardment of white supremacy ideology. Now, some of you think that because you're conscious, these subliminal suggestions don't affect you. But that would be like saying that because I have a plant-based diet, I can eat a foot-long steak and cheese sub. And my body is only going to absorb the plant-based material and not the steak and cheese sub.
$1 million on that table. $500,000 if you split it. $1 million if you don't. I'll let you two sort that out.
Because that's who you are. Some scared little girl who pretends to be strong, but is really just weak.
Your truth. You're nothing but a piece of ass. That's what I saw when I first talked to you in the office that day. Because I knew you'd put up. That's all you're really good for. Dirty, rough sex. I'm too ashamed to tell anyone about it. That's how foul you are, you disgusting slut.
Do you know what the scariest thing is? To not know your place in this world. To not know why you're here. That's... it's just an awful feeling. Victor. I almost gave up hope. There were so many times I questioned myself. Killed all those people. But I vowed it. So many sacrifices. Just to find you. Jesus Christ. Now that we know who you are, I know who I am. I'm not a mistake. It all makes sense. In a comic, you know how you can tell who the arch-villain's going to be? He's the exact opposite of the hero. And most times they're friends, like you and me. I should have known way back when. You know why, David? Because of the kids.
Department of Justice. You're going to America to face trial.
You shouldn't, my friend.
Captain Phillips is free. All of your friends are dead. It's over. You're going to America now.
But the body is most definitely going to attempt to absorb everything that you ingest. Everything that you put in your mouth. So, but we're not going to go too much into detail of subliminal suggestion today. What we want to do is share with you what came to us in meditation on this Sunday, December the 7th, 2014. During meditation, it came to us that we absolutely need more black law enforcement officers. It's of the utmost importance that we have more black law enforcement officers. Now, what kind of black law enforcement officers are we talking about here? Are we talking about agents of white supremacy, like Ray Hagan's law enforcement officers? Or are we talking about black natural law enforcement officers? There's a difference between white supremacy law and natural law. Okay? Now, we don't want to go too much into detail about that either. But we do want you to understand what natural law commands. How do you know what natural law commands? Do you need a law book? Do you need to go to law school? You most certainly do not. The only thing you need to do is observe nature. Observe the animal kingdom, the insect world, observe plants, observe the weather. You need to observe the behavior, yes, the behavior of nature. And that's how you'll understand what natural law is. Okay? So, we just wanted to share with you now, we need more black natural law enforcement officers. Huh? So will you take the pledge? Will you take the oath? Like so many of our black law enforcement officers pledge allegiance to white supremacy law. All law enforcement officers, all white supremacy law enforcement officers must protect and serve the interests of white supremacy first and foremost. But if you have a conscience, you also may be a double agent. So while you are protecting and serving the interests of white supremacy, on the other hand, you are a natural law enforcement officer. All right? And so you are in place. The universe has put you in place to check those white supremacy law enforcement officers when they are attacking the indigenous people of the world. That's your duty. That's your assignment from the forces of nature and from the universe, or some would say from God. I tend to get confused because to some degree and on some levels, white supremacy law lines up or parallels natural law. But that's on some levels. The devil, if you will, to use a religious term, mixes truth with falsehood. There has to be a mixture of truth in the falsehood so that you will begin to believe the falsehood. So, of course, white supremacy law parallels on some levels and to some degree natural law. But you can't let that fool you into believing that white supremacy law is the law above all other laws. So again, if you are a black man or a black woman, this world needs more indigenous natural law enforcement officers. And your job is to protect and serve the interests of natural law. This has been Daku Akabo Wa Akatu.